Good morning, students. Myself K. Lakshmi, assistant professor in the department of SNH, Chebrol Engineering College. Title lasers. Topic helium neon laser. In the last session, we discussed about the ruby laser, or it is also named as a solid type of laser. So this is another type of laser, that is helium neon laser. Helium neon laser was first gas laser which was operated by Jevon, Bennett and Harriet of Bell Telephone Labs in 1961. So here, this helium neon gas laser is a gas type of laser. So this is the schematic diagram construction of helium neon laser. So here, the laser output is in a continuous mode. So that's why helium neon laser is named as continuous laser. And here it is a 4 energy level scheme, so it is also named as a 4 energy level laser system. So for every so here the continuous output power, which is in a milliwatts, that means a very less output here, very less intensity of a laser light is developed in this process. But it is a continuous laser. That means continuous laser with a low out power. So basing on this property, this helium neon gas laser is useful for making holograms and also in interferometer experiment. So it is a 4-level laser system. So it is also named as a 4 energy level laser. Now let us briefly discuss about the construction of helium neon laser. So here, this is called, this entire is called quartz tube. So this is the quartz tube. Actually, we have 3 components for laser production: active medium, pumping source, optical cavity. Actually, this is the quartz tube. Quartz tube means initially it has no medium. That means vacuum is present here. Now, these are the electrodes. So these are the electrodes. So electrodes on both sides of the quartz tube. Now these electrodes are connected to a generator, frequency generator. Now, this quartz tube is filled with a mixture of helium and neon gas. Now, at the ends of the quartz tube, there is a fully reflecting mirror and a partially reflecting mirror. So this is the fully reflecting mirror and this is the partially reflecting mirror. So these fully reflecting and partially reflecting mirrors are act as a optical resonator. So this is the parts in the helium neon laser. Now, what is active medium here? Actually, in this quartz tube, we have a mixture of helium and neon. So helium, under the pressure of 1 mm of Hg, and neon gas under the pressure of 0.1 mm of Hg. That means helium pressure compared with mercury. So as compared with the pressure of mercury, the pressure of helium is taken as a 1 mm. Similarly, neon gas pressure as compared with mercury, it is taking as a 0.1 mm. That is the meaning of here. So in this quartz tube, we have mixture of helium and neon. That is helium under the pressure of 1 mm of Hg and neon gas under the pressure of 0.1 mm of Hg. That means simply helium and neon are in the ratio 10 is to 1. 10 is to 1. This mixture is placed in a long, narrow discharge tube. So this is the discharge tube. This discharge tube having diameter 1.5 centimeters and having length from 10 to 100 centimeters long. That means we can choose any long, any length from 10 to 100 centimeters. But diameter is 1.5 centimeters. So this diameter is 1.5 centimeters. And the length may be 10 to 100 centimeters. Now, what is the pumping source here? Actually, this is the discharge tube. So this is the discharge tube. It having two nodes, cathode and anode here. Now, what is the pumping source in this method? This is the electric discharge tube pumping method. That means the electrodes are connected to a high voltage power supply. So in gas laser, since the atoms are characterized by sharp energy levels as compared to those in solids. Now here, the electric discharge method is used for the pumping of atoms to the higher energy level. That means when we giving some high voltage to these electrodes, then electrons are moved from this side to this electrode to other electrode here. So when this path, that means when electrons are moved from this side to this side, in between there is an atoms here. So which atoms? There are helium and neon atoms. Now these electrons are collision with these atoms. Now this collision energy is used by the atoms for excitation process. So that is the pumping source. So simply pumping source in this method is electric discharge tube pumping method. So how we how the electric discharge pumping method process is going? Once again, I repeat, when we giving some power supply to these electrodes, then electrons are moved from this side to this electrode to this electrode. In between the path, there are helium. It is filled with the helium and the neon gas. That means it is filled with the helium and the neon atoms. Now these electrons are bombarded to or collision to these helium and neon atoms. That collision energy is used, those active atoms, for use of excitation process. So simply, in this helium neon laser, electric discharge tube method is used. Then optical cavity. So at the ends of the glass tube, we have fully reflecting mirror and partially reflecting mirror. Both the combination is nothing but optical resonator. Now, what is the working? So here we have combination of two gases, helium and neon. But out of helium, neon is the active medium, even though it is in less percentage. So here we have helium energy levels, three energy level system, He1, He2, He3. That means helium possesses a three energy level system, where neon having six energy level system, Ne1, Ne2, NE3, NE4, NE5, NE6. So this is the three energy level system for helium, and this is the 6 energy level system of neon. But there is a transition takes place between there is a collision transition takes place between 2 and 4 energy level. So simply it is named as a 4 level pumping scheme. Helium 3 energy level systems are namely He1, He2, He3, and neon energy levels are named as NE1, NE2, NE3, NE4, NE5, and NE6. Okay, now when we power on this generator, now these electrons are accelerated and they move from electrodes from this side to this side. Among that, they have helium and neon atoms are there. So even though active medium is neon, but first collision of electrons takes place by helium atoms. That means if we have helium atom and neon atoms there, so first electron is collision with the helium atoms. So this collision of energy is used by the helium atoms, that means ground state energy level atoms, and they excited to He2 energy level, and some of the atoms are excited to He3 level. That means whatever the collision energy, some of the atoms are move from He1 to He2, and some of the atoms transition from He1 to He3. So this is completely excitation takes place by the collision of electrons. Actually, we have helium and neon both atoms in the discharge tube, but even though in collision process, helium atom are primary reactive. So automatically, by absorbing this collision energy, helium atom are excited to He2 energy level, and some of the atoms are excited to He3 level. And now, this collision is transferred to neon atoms. For example, the energy at E3 is maybe 15 volts, for example. The energy of atoms here is 10 volts. Okay. Now, we have 6 energy levels here. Out of 6 energy levels, the same energy is, that means He2 energy is equivalent to NE4 energy. Due to equivalent energy values, the collision is taking place by NE4 atoms. Okay. That means these collision, first neon atoms is bombarding neon atoms. After helium atoms collision, this energy is transferred to neon atoms. So whatever the neon atoms are there, they immediately jump to some of the atoms NE4 and some of the atoms to NE6. So directly they excite to NE4 and NE6. So here the collision is takes place to neon atom here in the ground state. By using this collision energy, neon atoms are directly jumped to NE4, some of the atoms to jump to NE4, and some of the atoms are transition to NE6. Why they are transition takes place in NE4 and NE6? The main reason is the atoms are having equivalent energy. They reach to equivalent energy. That means He2 energy is equivalent to NE4. That's why whatever the atoms here, in a neon ground level, they directly rise to NE4 energy level, because NE4 energy is equivalent to He2 energy. At the same time, and some of the atoms are transition takes place to NE6 energy level, because NE6 energy level is equivalent to He3 energy level. So automatically the atoms are raised to NE6 energy level. Now NE6 is a excitation level. That means whatever the atoms here, lifetime is very less. So here this spontaneous emission process is going. So what is meant by spontaneous emission? Without giving any extra energy, they jump to higher energy level to lower energy. In this process also photons are emitted, but these photons are non-radiative transitions. That means ordinary light. So having wavelength 3.39 micrometers. And there is a transition takes place between NE6 to NE3 also. But from NE6 to NE3 case, it is a stimulated emission case. So we already discussed that in stimulation emission process, we have laser light. So automatically here, the laser light having wavelength 6,328 angstroms. And some of the atoms are transition takes place from NE4 to NE3 with a non-radiative transition having wavelength 1.15 micrometer. So it is also a ordinary light. And all the atoms from NE3 to NE2 is also spontaneous emission with a velocity, with a wavelength of 6,000 angstroms. After that, all the atoms in the NE2 level is de-excitation by the collision and they reach it to ground level. So this is the process here in an energy level system. Again, these atoms, these photons are reached here, that is partially reflective mirror. So due to partially reflective mirror, they move again backside. So by lasing action process continuously, a high intensity beam of laser light is emitted here. So this is the process in helium neon laser. Okay. Once again, I clearly explained step by step. You can easily understand. So, helium, there are three active energy levels, He1, He2, He3. Neon having energy levels, NE1, NE2, NE3, NE3, NE4, NE5, NE6. When power is switched on, then ions of the ionizations, some of the atoms in the gaseous mixture, the helium atoms are more readily excitable than neon atoms because they are lighter. That means when the electrons are bombarding helium and neon atoms, first helium atoms are reacted fastly because helium atoms are lighter as compared with the neon. Now this energetic electrons are excited helium atoms by collision, then they can easily jump to He2 energy level to He3. But these two are metastable state. With passage of current through the discharge tube more and more, then helium atoms are accumulated in the higher energy state. These helium atoms are returned to the ground state. So by giving external energy, then these helium atoms are moved to ground state. So now again they bombard the neon atoms in the ground state energy level. So in the ground state energy level, now the transition takes place. Exactly these atoms in the ground state, the transition takes place from Ne4 level to directly Ne6 level, because the energies of He2 is equal to Ne4 and He3 energy is equal to Ne4, Ne6. That means Ne4 and Ne6 of neon atom energy states are coincide with the energies of He2 and He3 of the helium atom. So that's why when helium atoms are bombarding the or collision the ground state level of the neon atoms, immediately the atoms in this ground state energy level are directly raised to Ne4 and Ne6, because here these are equivalent energies, helium He2 and Ne4, He3 and Ne6. And the next one is, now the probability of energy transfer from helium atoms to neon atoms is more, as there are 10 helium atoms to 1 neon atom in the mixture. For this reason, transfer of energy from neon to helium is extremely small. Now here Ne4 and Ne6 are metastable state. At ordinary temperature, generally transition from Ne3 and Ne4, Ne5 are populated, and population inversion is achieved between Ne3 and Ne5. So this is the actual reaction, Ne3 to Ne5. This is wrong. Ne3 to Ne5, there is a population existing. And the remaining all transitions, that is Ne6 to Ne5, Ne6 to Ne3, Ne4, Ne3, all the cases are non-radiative transitions. Only the transition takes place between Ne5 and Ne3 is only with 6,328 angstroms is only laser light. So this type of laser is due to photon causes laser emission. It is also named as photon causes laser emission. And remaining all the transitions are non-radiative transition, that is 1.15 micrometer, that is from Ne4 to Ne3, and Ne3 to Ne2, that is 6,000 angstrom unit. These are all non-radiative transition, that means they are ordinary light. So what are the applications of helium neon laser? It had wide range of applications because it is a coherent, highly, extremely narrow line width, very small narrow width. So for example, this is the narrow width, very small, but whereas in ruby laser, the width may be like that. So very narrow line width, and they are used in laser printing, barcode reading. You observe in a DMart, in a wholesale shops, each and every item having barcode. So barcode reading is with the help of laser light. When we focus the laser light on this barcode reading, we can easily observe what is the value of the item with the help of system, and also holography, optical communications, target aiming devices used in guns, and next surveying means building surveying or large river reverse surveying, laser surgeries, interferometers and measurements of large distances, like distance between two planets, Earth and Moon, like that. So these are all the applications of helium neon laser. And moreover, applications of overall lasers that will be discussed in the next session. It is very important concept. So this is about the helium neon laser. Thank you to all.